Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up customers in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. If you invoice customers, then you definitely want to set up profiles for your customers in QuickBooks. Setting up your customers will allow you to do a couple things. One, quickly create invoices for your customers since all of your customer data like billing address, shipping address, and due date will automatically populate from the customer profile. Second, it will allow you to easily track sales by customer, which could be a great way to get to know what your customers like so you can market to them strategically. First, we'll explain how to manually set up customers in QuickBooks. However, if you have more than 10 customers to set up in QuickBooks, I recommend that you proceed to the next section of this lesson, how to set up customers using an Excel or CSV file. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. Once you've signed into your QuickBooks Online account, go ahead and navigate to the Customer Center on the left-hand menu bar. And then we want to go ahead and click the New Customer button to the far right. This is our new customer setup window. First, you want to enter the customer's first and last name. This would be for individual customers. If you have a business that you are setting up, your commercial customers, then you want to go ahead and enter the company name right below this field here. The display name field will automatically populate based on the information that was entered above, either in the first or last name or the company name field. The address tab is where you enter the billing address for your customer. This should be the mailing address where you send your customers their invoices. We also have a field, if you ship products to your customers, there's a separate field to enter a shipping address. All you have to do is actually remove the check mark here and complete these fields with the shipping address information. However, if the bill to and the ship to address are exactly the same, you want to go ahead and put that check mark back there. All right, so that is it for address tab. Let's go over to the payment and billing tab. And this first field, preferred payment method. You can indicate here what method your customer prefers to pay with. If it is a credit card, then you can enter the credit card information here so you have it on file. While it is convenient to keep your customer's credit card information on file so that you don't have to ask for it every time, it is also imperative that you safeguard this information. For example, if you have multiple users who access QuickBooks data, be sure that you limit access to only those who actually need this information. Preferred delivery method. You can indicate here what method your customer prefers to receive their invoices. During the lesson on how to set up invoices, sales receipts, and estimates, we walked through how to set up default delivery methods for all customers. The options here are to print later or send later. Print later will allow you to print your customer's invoice and mail it later. Send later will allow you to email your customers their invoices. If you want to change the default delivery method for a customer, this is where you want to do that. Payment terms. In the setting up invoices, sales receipt, and estimates lesson, we set up default payment terms for all customers. If you want to change the default payment terms for any customer, you are able to do so in the customer profile here as well. So for this customer, we will go ahead and set terms of net 30. The opening balance field can be used to enter an outstanding balance for a customer. For example, if you are converting from another bookkeeping system to QuickBooks and your customer has some outstanding invoices, then you can enter the total outstanding balance here when you set them up in QuickBooks. When that customer sends you a check, you can apply it to the opening balance in QuickBooks. If you'd like to learn more about offering payment terms and invoicing terms, click this link. Some additional information that you may want to keep track of in QuickBooks are notes, tax information, and attachments. Let's start with the notes tab. You can enter any additional information here that you would like to keep track of for your customer. For example, additional contact names and telephone numbers. This information is for internal purposes and will not be visible to your customers. Tax info. You can enter your customer's resale number in this field. This will be for customers who are not subject to sales tax. And the attachment tab. You are able to attach any documents that you would like to keep on file for this customer. So for example, if you ask the customer to provide you with a copy of their resale permit, then you could attach it to their customer profile here. Also, any signed contracts or copies of email correspondence would be great to keep on file as well. Once we've completed this information, we can go ahead and save it, and we can go back to the customer center and take a look at our customer that we just set up. So this is John Smith. If we go back to the initial customer center page and scroll down to John Smith, you can easily edit the information by clicking the name of the customer here. And then over to the right, we've got an edit button that we can go ahead and select. And that will take us back to the screen where we can edit any of the information that we just entered. Once you've made any changes that are necessary, you can save that information. So that wraps up the lesson on how to manually set up customers in QuickBooks Online. If you have more than 10 customers to set up in QuickBooks, I recommend that you put the information in an Excel document and import the data into QuickBooks Online. This will save you a lot of time over manually setting up customers in QuickBooks Online. QuickBooks allows you to capture a lot of data about customers, but the key fields that you should include in your Excel or CSV file are the first and last name for individual customers, the company name for a business or your commercial customers, email address, telephone number, and billing address. Don't worry about the format of the spreadsheet, just make sure that you include these key fields in the spreadsheet. Once you have your spreadsheet ready, you are ready to import the data into QuickBooks. To import into QuickBooks, we want to go ahead and go to the Customer Center, and we want to click the drop down to the right of New Customer and select Import Customers. On this next screen, you want to navigate to the location where you have your import file saved. So go ahead and click Browse, locate the file, and once you've located the file, click on it and then click Open. Make sure that the file name has populated in the field there, and if so, we can go ahead and move to the next screen. If you want to see a sample Excel file, just click the Download a Sample File here. Keep in mind that there is no need to reformat your spreadsheet. In the next step, we are going to map the data so that QuickBooks will pull the right data from your spreadsheet. In this screen, we are going to tell QuickBooks which field in the spreadsheet to pull the customer information from. By doing this, we will ensure that the information is imported into the right fields in QuickBooks. So the first field is name in QuickBooks. On the right-hand side, where it says your field, these are the fields that are pulling from our import file. If you click the drop-down, you will see the column headings there. And so notice that customer name is what we want to match to this name field. So we've got the green check mark there. If we look at the drop-down and we look at the columns, we do not have any company information in this field. So we want to go ahead and select no match. Next field is email. And so for the email, we do have an email address in this field, and so we're going to match that to customer email. Phone number, once again, if you click the drop-down, you'll notice we do not have a phone number field for in our spreadsheet, but we do have a cell number. So we'll go ahead and say no match for phone number, drop down to the mobile field, and we want the cell number column to be pulled for that. Perfect. We don't have a fax number in this spreadsheet, so this will be a no match again. And same for website. No website information, so no match. The next field is the address. We do have that, street address match. We've got city, state, and zip. So everything with a green check mark will import into QuickBooks. So you should have noticed a couple things. The fields in your spreadsheet do not have to match the field names exactly in QuickBooks. So notice in QuickBooks it says name, we've got customer name, and that's perfectly fine. QuickBooks is more concerned about pulling the data than the actual column name that we have. The other thing that you might notice is we are able to have additional information in our spreadsheet that may not be imported into QuickBooks. And so that's fine as well. Just indicate the no match. Whether we have the information in the file or whether we don't, you can put the no match there and that will work for that. Once we have completely mapped the data, we are ready to go to the next screen to confirm before we import. So in this screen, this is our final opportunity to review the data and how it will import into QuickBooks. We want to be sure to double check that the number of records agree with our spreadsheet. So on this screen, as you can see, it says 10 records are ready to be imported. So we want to make sure that that's how many customers we have in our spreadsheet and make sure that matches. The other thing that we want to do is we want to verify that the information is in the correct fields. Does the name field have the customer name? Does the email address field have email address info in it? Mobile, street, so on and so forth. So we want to make sure that the information is going to import properly into QuickBooks. If for some reason something's incorrect and we need to change it, you can click that back button. Now we're ready to import. So click the import button. And so at the top it says 9 out of 9 customers have successfully imported. You may need to change some information for a customer. And so you can do that at any time in QuickBooks. You want to go ahead and make sure you're in the customer center. And then you simply can just click on the customer's name and it will take us to that customer's profile. If you go up to the edit button and click that, we are back at this screen where we can change any of this information that we need to, and then we can save our changes. Similar to products and services, you cannot delete a customer once you have used them in a transaction. So for example, once you have created an invoice for a customer, that is considered a transaction. This invoice or transaction is linked to financial statements, and those financial statements will be used when you file your taxes. However, if you decide you no longer will do business with the customer, you can inactivate a customer just like you can for products and services. Inactivate will simply hide the customer from the customer center, but they will still appear in all financial records if there's been a transaction. To inactivate a customer from the customer center, select the customer and then click on the drop-down arrow to the right, and you go ahead and select Make Inactive. QuickBooks wants to confirm that this is the action that we want to take, and so we'll say yes. And so now our customer is no longer appearing on the list here. That wraps up the section on how to set up customers in QuickBooks Online. To access this course or any of the others in the series, just click this link. For a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.